Good afternoon, everyone. So today's topic is displacement current and displacement current density. Okay. So in the last class, we have derived Maxwell's equations, that is by using Faraday's law. Okay. So today we will derive another Maxwell's equation using Ampere's circuitous law. Okay. And meanwhile, we discuss what is displacement current and displacement current density. Okay, so according to Ampere's circuitous law, that is phi of H is equal to G. Okay, so according to Ampere's circuitous law, phi of H is equal to J for the static electromagnetic field. For static electromagnetic field. Okay, and we are now studying time varying fields. So the fields which are varying with respect to time. Okay. So this equation holds for static the Maxwell's curl equation for electrostatic and its modified for the time varying situation to satisfy Faraday's law. Okay, so we will consider the Maxwell's curl equation for magnetic field, that is Ampere's circuitous law, for a time varying condition. Okay, so by taking the divergence of the current, okay, so we are taking this divergence on both the sides. Is going to be equal to divergence of G. But we know that divergence of a curl of a vector is always equal to 0. Okay, so this is identity. So it is identically 0. Okay, so but we also know that by continuity equation, equation for the current, current density, that is divergence of J is equal to minus del rho by dt, where rho v is volume charge density. Okay. This is the case. So, which is not equal to 0. Which is not equal to 0. Okay, so the this equation, okay, so this is equal to minus del rho by dt and is not equal to 0. Okay, so this LHS is equal to 0, but RHS is not equal to 0. So this equation obviously is incompatible for the time variant condition. Okay, so we must modify. Okay, and we have to do some adjustment to find the, so this Ampere's circuitous law, so it is very inconsistent. Okay, so this is not compatible with time varying fields. Okay, so this not fit in time varying fields. It is true for the static magnetic field. Okay, so we have to modify this equation for time varying magnetic fields, electromagnetic fields. Okay. So this equation has unrealistic limitation, so we must amend before we accept for the time varying fields. Okay. So that is, let's suppose this equation, curl of H is equal to J plus G. Okay. So let takes a unknown vector, that is vector J. Okay. The vector G. Now take divergence on both the side. Okay. So this is identically equal to 0. This will be equal to divergence of J plus divergence of E, or divergence of E is equal to minus J divergence of J, and minus divergence of J is equal to del only by B. And also by Maxwell's first equation, electrostatic field. So V is equal to divergence of D. Okay. So this will be equal to del by del T is gradient of, okay. As gradient of unknown vector G is equal to So substitute the value of G here. So we get amendment equation of Encke's law is del V by. So this is the modified equations of Encke's law. Okay. So curl of H is equal to J plus del V by D. And this del D by dt is equal to JD. JD is displacement current density. Or it can be written as curl of H is equal to J plus J. It is applicable for time varying fields only. Okay, so this is applicable for time varying fields only. For static field, curl of H is equal to J. So for static electromagnetic field, this is equation, and we have done some modification in this equation, which is valid for this time varying field. That is, curl of H is equal to J plus JD. The JD is displacement current density. So this is modified equation of Encke's law, which is done by Maxwell. Okay, and this is one of the Maxwell's equation, which is derived from Encke's equation in point form. Okay, so J is and J is conduction current density. Conduction current density. So again, this is the relationship between J H and B. Okay, so this is electric flux density and it is magnetic field index. Okay, so this equation is relationship between H and J, and yesterday we have studied the curl of E, which is the special perturbation of E is equal to minus del E by E. Okay. This equation, these are two Maxwell's equation. So this gives relationship between H and D, and this gives relationship between E and B. Okay. So this is valid for time varying magnetic electromagnetic field. So, as we know, the current I, conduction current I, is equal to surface integral J dot ds. Okay, so this is conduction current. So, similarly, we can write displacement current id is equal to surface integral J dot ds. Okay, so this is displacement. This is id. Id is equal to double integration J dot ds. Okay. Here, J is equal to del V by dt. So id is equal to surface integral J D is equal to surface integral del D by dt dot ds. Okay, so id is equal to this much. Now, so curl of H is equal to J dot K plus del D by dt. Okay, so this is conduction current density and this is displacement current density. Taking surface integral both the sides and the power H dot ds is equal to surface integral J dot ds plus del D by dt ds. Now from source theorem, surface integral curl of H of ds is equal to H dot B, no surface integral H dot B. Okay, so we can write, if we can substitute here, so this will be H dot B dl is equal to the surface integral J dot ds plus surface integral del D by dt So this J dot d s is equal to conduction current. So closed line integral H dot d l is equal to conduction current I plus this quantity is flow surface integral del d by d t dot d s. Okay. So for static field, electromagnetic field. We know that H dot integral is equal to I. Okay. So this holds I n plus. It is applicable for electromagnetic field only. Okay, and it is for time varying field. It is applicable for time varying field only. Okay. Now we can write this. So H dot d l will be equal to I plus. This is displacement current. Okay. So this is Maxwell's equation. Which is derived from Faraday's Ampere's law. Okay, so this is a modification of Ampere's law, which is valid for time varying fields. Okay, so first. Maxwell's equation. So first, this is in integral form. H dot d l is equal to conduction current I and surface integral del d by d t dot d s. This is integral form and curl of H is equal to conduction current plus del d by. So this is in point form or differential. Okay, so this is the point form or differential form of the Maxwell's equation, which is derived from Ampere's law. Okay. So this is for time varying fields. And for this steady field, S dot dl is equal to I and curl of H is equal to J. And this is for time varying fields. Okay. So now, what is the physical significance of this current I? Okay, that is equal to displacement. Okay. So now we see its physical significance. Okay. So this is Maxwell's equation derived from Ampere's law or modified equation of Ampere's Ampere's law. Okay. So Ampere's law is inconsistent. Okay. So for time varying fields. Okay. So we have to consider the displacement current also. Okay. So Maxwell has given this amendment, that is curl of H is equal to J plus del D by dt, okay, or close line integral S dot dl is equal to I plus surface integral del D by del T dot ds. Okay. So, now consider U, which is subjected to magnetic field uniform time varying field. Okay. And we put a capacitor in between this U. So this is time varying field. So whenever our loop is subjected to a time varying magnetic field, EMF will be induced in this loop, and this EMF will be equal to, then this will be equal to V naught cos omega t. The current in the loop, so EMF induced in this loop, and current will flow through this loop. Okay. And current will be given by C dV by dt. Okay. So this is EMF. So this will be equal to C dV by dt V naught cos omega t. This will be equal to C V naught omega sine omega. Okay, so this is the value negative I is equal to this. Okay. And also capital C is equal to epsilon A upon D. So substituting here, so I will be equal to C V naught. So V naught omega epsilon A by D into sine omega T. Okay. So where epsilon is the permittivity and the dielectric inside the capacitor, A is the area, surface area. And D is the separation between these two parallel plate capacitor. Okay, so I is equal to this much minus epsilon naught A by D V naught. So now let us consider a loop here, a small loop here. So let us consider a loop. Okay, so this is a current carrying loop. Okay, so which is produced due to this varying magnetic field. So according to Ampere's circuit law, so if we apply the, let's suppose this is a K loop. Okay, so applying Ampere's circuit law. To the closed loop K. So H dot dl will be equal to I. We are applying this loop. Okay, this imaginary loop. So this is loop for K, and this current is I, which is enclosed by this loop. Okay. So this is equal to J dot ds for surface one. This will be equal to J dot ds, which is equal to I n k. And this I k is nothing, this is the current which is flowing through this. So this will be equal to I. Okay. Now, if we take a loop, okay, such that, so a new loop which encircles given plane of the capacitor, okay, like this. So if we use a this balloon shaped surface, okay, so let's suppose it is J, okay, this is this K dash, K one, okay, and that passes between the capacitor plates, okay. So again, so this will be equal to H dot here, okay, this will be K dash, this will be equal to current K dash is equal to J dot ds, okay, or K dash is equal to 0. So I enclosed will be equal to 0, okay, because no conduction current flow through this loop, okay, through this loop. So no conduction current is flowing through this loop. Okay, so since in between this capacitor there is no current flowing, so this conduction current is not flowing through the capacitor plate. Okay, so this is the contradictory to the in view of the fact the same closed path L is used. Okay, so it should not be equal to 0. So this is the contradiction. So this implicit law is failing here. So to resolve this conflict, we need to include the displacement current in the ampere circuit law. So total current density is J plus J. Okay. So now J will be equal to J plus J. Okay, so here the concept of the current density, displacement current density, comes in the picture. Okay, so now voltage. Maxwell had done some experiments. Okay, if you keep a needle inside this capacitor, okay, so then this capacitor will deplete. Okay, so what he had observed that this needle, magnetic needle, is deflecting inside this inside the parallel capacitor plate. Okay, so that means some magnetic field is present inside the two parallel plates. Okay, so as in last class we have studied Faraday's law. So now Faraday suggested that the due to time varying magnetic field, current produces. Okay, so first EMF induces and current will flow through the closed loop. Okay, so due to this time varying magnetic field, so time varying magnetic field, so there will be a current induced in this loop. Okay, so due to this time varying magnetic field, so the EMF will induce here, induce EMF, and due to which current will flow through the loop. Okay, so the current flowing through this loop, that it is I. Okay, so this is nothing, this is conduction current. Okay, and here it is also. So what is happening here inside this capacitor? Okay, and this needle is deflected. So certainly there will be, and it will deflect, and after some time it will come rest to a position, a particular position. Okay, so here the electric field is changing. Okay, and here due to the electric field, a magnetic field changes. Okay, so change in electric field produces magnetic field. Which deflect this needle. Okay, so as we have seen that current I is equal to, sorry, JD is equal to del V by G. Okay, or it can be written as epsilon naught del V by del V. So this is rate of change of electric field with respect to time. Okay, so whenever there will be change in electric field, it gives rise to a magnetic field, and in turn it will give a current. Okay, this current density, and JD is equal to this much. And if you deviate, so ID will be equal to surface integral JD dot ds. Okay, so this current between this plate is ID, which is flowing through this plate is ID. Okay, so first this current is IC, and between this parallel plate is ID, and again after this parallel plate, so this is again conduction current. Okay, like this. So between this parallel plate, conduction current is flowing, which is due to the change of electric field. Okay, so due to this electric field, a current will produce between this parallel plates of the capacitor, and the continuity of current is maintained like this. Okay, so this ID is equal to, so we have seen that ID is equal to minus V naught epsilon A by D omega into sine omega T. So ID is equal to this much. Okay, so for this loop, so H dot DL for K dash will be equal to JD. Okay, so here JD is present, K dash JD dot DS. Okay, so which is equal to, for the loop surface integral, del V by DT dot DS, which is equal to, okay, which is equal to IT. So we obtain the same current from either surface through the conduction through conduction current in this K, and in K prime it is displacement current. Okay, so the Ampere's circuit law holds good for both the conditions. Okay, so between these parallel plates, this two capacitor plates, displacement current flows. Okay, its value is this much. So displacement current is associated with time varying electric fields. Okay. So this is all about displacement current. Okay. Thank you, class.